Yeah, it's been a long time between drinks, since 2014, my last test, and to get back in the side in the first place was something I really held close to my heart. I was so happy to be able to walk back on the field with the Australian test team with the baggy green cap on, and just was so filled with joy when I got told I had the opportunity to do that again. So I suppose I just didn't really want to waste the opportunity, just didn't want to make it my last test, and that's for sure. I know how bad it felt when I played that last game in Dubai and didn't play again. I know how bad that felt, so just wanted to make it count. Hopefully this just either ticks something inside that just I can continue to be consistent. I think that's always been the biggest thing that the coaches, selectors have always wanted, is consistency. So if I can keep producing long innings and bagging long periods of time, building partnerships with other players, I think that's going to go a long way to firstly holding my spot, but secondly winning games for Australia. It was probably more the emotion of the whole night that I had as well. Like you go to sleep 82 not out, you've just put on 150 with a skipper. I thought about it all night, and I went through about 300 to 400 different scenarios that could have happened the next day, and most of them weren't good. it was just so much emotion just fell out of me as soon as I got that 100, and everything about it now, I'm getting a frog in my throat. So it's just as special a moment I've had in my career, and hopefully it's not the last. I've spoken a lot about Red Bull cricket and a lot of interviews that I've done. I've spoken at lengths about how I've always felt like Red Bull cricket's my best format, and to be able to show that at the test level is something that I'm extremely proud of, and I can finally show people with a result instead of just talking. So just incredibly relieved to have played innings like that. I was in a place where I doubted whether I'd play test cricket again and whether I'd have the chance to put the cap back on, and I just did everything I could on and off the field. I trained as hard as I could. I changed things in my technique. I had numerous conversations with different people. I tried to stay in the loop as much as I could, and just kept on asking questions, and just changed people's perception of what they thought Glenn Maxwell was doing. They knew exactly every time. They go, "What's Maxi doing?" "Well, we know he's been training. We know he's been in the gym, or we know he's been over here playing golf." It doesn't matter. I was always in contact with them, and just having those conversations just made people lose those perceptions a little bit, and you gain a bit of trust off people as well. So for them to have that trust in me, it probably led to them giving me this opportunity. And as I said, when I got told that I was playing this test, there was a lot of emotion in that as well. And I just remember going home that night and just being so excited to put on the cap the next day. I was planning on sweeping. I was just sort of waiting for the line of delivery at certain stages, and they bowled quite straight to me, so I just never really got the option. And then it was later on the day, I think Ashwin bowled one, I tried to reverse it, and instead of trying to actually hit it, I tried to paddle it. So I was only trying to get a couple of runs and move a fielder then, but Steve came down and said, "Look, you've been hitting the ball pretty well straight, don't worry about it." And I was like, "Yeah, good point." Good point. So I put that in the bin, and then I probably should have brought it out after I got to 100 when the ball started spinning, because there was no real chance that he could have got me out if I was playing, because it was probably a safer shot than defending at that stage, because he was bowling above 90 k's an hour and pitching in the middle, and every now and then I was skidding, every now and then I was spinning, so it's probably a better time to bring it out then instead.